Hi.
Thank you so much for being here with me today. So for today's video, I got this cute little makeup eraser from Sephora, the original, and it's a tiny little mini one. It's so cute. And it was free because I used my rewards at Sephora and I wanted to test it out. I don't have the full-size one, so we are gonna do something fun today. I want to know, how many times do I have to wash this baby in order to get my face fully clean? So let's go ahead and grab some warm water. Oh, the instructions says to use the short-haired side to wash your face. And then it says to use the long-haired side, which is this side, to exfoliate. Make sure you get all those crevices and get all that makeup off. But to the touch, these feel the same. So I'm not really sure how it's supposed to exfoliate. Oh, and the instructions also says to wash it in the washing machine with your towels. So right now I'm rinsing it. Make sure it's clean from when it was made in the factory. I'm using warm water and I'm just rubbing it. I need to put my hair up. And by the way, I have a lot of things on my face. I have foundation. I have concealer under my eyes. I've had this makeup on since this morning. It is almost 10 p.m. right now, and I've had it on since about 8 a.m. So, yeah, 14 hours. Sorry, I'm not good with that. Eraser, not be warm anymore. So let's go ahead and squeeze it, and let's begin. I'm going to start with my forehead. I want to see how much makeup is on this after getting my nose, my forehead, my cheeks. Get that concealer out. It is tricky. Getting concealers out is tricky. Make sure I get really close to my hairline, really close to my ear. Get my neck. Get my upper lip. So we're using both sides of this. This is what the first side looks like. And now we're gonna use the clean, long bristle side. Look at the cheek, look at the eye. Get all the crevices of the lips, the nose, the eyes, the temples, the forehead. I'm trying to get this thing as dirty as possible before I wash it the first time. When I wash it, but rinse out all this gunk out. And I'm just using water on this, and so far it's removing everything pretty good. I know, please forgive me. I'm like rubbing on my eyelashes with that. I want to stay young. And I'm trying to use every little corner out of this. And this is what it looks like so far. This is the long hair side, and this is the short hair side. So this one has my foundation, my concealer, my highlighters. This side has the remainder of my concealer, my makeup, my highlighters, and my makeup for my eyes. So let's try to get this more dirty. Clean that mascara out. Oh, this thing is looking so good. Like, you can tell this thing in just one use how good it did. Like, look at all that foundation, but yet on this side you can see a little bit of the foundation and concealer, but it did such a good job at removing all my face makeup with just one side and makeup eraser that you can't even see much of the foundation, concealer, and, you know, highlighter on this one. Like, that's, I'm so impressed. So let's go ahead and see what this looks like after I rinse it out. So I used Truce Safe and Simple Hand Soap. It's unscented and it has pure organic castile soap. Okay, there we go. So I'm gonna go ahead and show you what it looks like now. And it looks brand spanking new, if you ask me. What do you think? Look at that. It looks beautiful. But before I put the soap on, it still had all the foundation on. It still had everything. Mascara, concealer. But now it is brand new looking. So let's go ahead and see what else this baby takes away from my face. You have to make faces when you clean your face. And I'm so sorry if I'm triggering you right now by rubbing my face. But I'm trying to really get in there. The right way to clean your face is maybe like this. And I still have to remove my matte lipsticks that I have on. I have like 4 or 5 layers of matte lipsticks on my face. And it's different colors too, because I was playing around with some of my light colored. This is what it looks like on one side. Let me see how dirty I can get it easier. It's impossible to clean your face. Like, do you make faces when you clean your face? I feel like it's so nearly impossible. My eyes are probably cussing the life out of me right now if they can talk. Get my ears really close to my hairline. And this is what it looks like after my second use, after rinsing it out once. So now let's go ahead and See what it does to my lips? How many swipes will it take to clean my lips? Let's see. Oh, wow. That was 1, 2. Let's take a different side. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Wow. It only took 12 swipes. That is impressive. OMG. All right, so right now, I'm gonna go ahead and rinse it for the second time and clean it out like it was a washing machine. It's out. So this is what it looks like after being washed with soap. It looks brand new, if you ask me. So far, I'm extremely impressed because this thing, like, took almost everything out of my face. Now I'm gonna use the other side for my eyes and for my lips. I'm gonna make sure I get my hairline, my ears, my neck, ears, temples, my eyebrows. And we're gonna see how dirty it is after using this the third time. After washing it twice. So there you go. You can still see some more foundation, concealer, maybe some lipstick. But so far, I am so impressed. I mean, this is ridiculous. This is my third time using it very harshly on my face, which I'm sorry for being hypocritical, but you shouldn't do this. You shouldn't do this if you want to stay young looking, you know, want to encourage wrinkles and tugging the eye again. Wow, I am so impressed. And this thing is tiny compared to the full one. So this tells me that with a full one, I can definitely clean my entire face with one use. Look at that. And this is tiny. I mean, look how tiny this thing is. I'm very happy I use this as my rewards for Sephora, because I did not want to spend $20 on the full-size one. This is what it looks like. It still looks the same as earlier. I mean, use some soap and clean it out and see what it looks like after rubbing it. Looks like after being washed with soap. And if you ask me, that's pretty close to how it was after using it the third time after washing it only twice. So now we've washed it 3 times, and let's see if I get some more goodies out of my face on this. So for this time, I'm gonna use it the way you should clean your face. Very gentle. And when you wanna pull towards your temple, towards your eyes, to reduce as much friction and gravity from taking over and making you have wrinkles. So you wanna pull upwards. And for your neck, you also wanna pull upwards. And then for your forehead, you wanna pull upwards as well. That's my lips. Stretch them out. Let's see. So the naked eye, this side that I use for my lips, looks completely clean. But this side, the one I use for the rest of my face, excuse me, looks dirty. It looks like you can still maybe see some foundation, some concealer, some setting powder. But we are going to continue using this until it is pretty clean. And so far it looks very clean, but I can still see some like brown hair. So let's go ahead and wash it based on how it was after using it 3 times. So now we're going to see, I'm going to wait a little bit more. I'm going to see if it removes anything. So I'm going to use this as directed. So it says for this last one, I'm going to use this side to clean and the long haired side to exfoliate. That's what the directions say. So let's go ahead and use the short haired side to see what else comes out of my face. I just thought I'm tugging. I'm being rough, which I don't recommend. So I'm sorry that I'm being hypocritical, but I do not recommend you do this. Like I said, I'm going to see what wrinkles and all that good stuff, but I'm just really trying to get in there, get all the crevices under my eyes, get the mascara out, my lips. That's a little dirty. Wrinkles my lash, I mean my own hairline, my ears, my neck, my other ear. Let's see what it looks like. So I think most of the stuff that's coming off is maybe from my neck, because for the first couple washes I didn't focus on my neck as much. So I think all this like dark colored foundation looking color is coming from my neck. And you probably can't see it, but I see some darkness in this area. Kind of like in this triangle right here. I need to close my lips. When I do this, because all these hair fibers are just falling all over the place. So now I'm gonna use the long hair side to exfoliate. I'm gonna let it a little bit. Alright, so to exfoliate, I'm going to rub in circular motions. And it doesn't feel any different than if I was using the other side, to be honest. So this is my, I think that's my 4th or 5th time using this after rinsing it 3 or 4 times. that's what this is. Circle of motions, okay, circle of motions. This is what it looks like. Yeah, I definitely see some. So I'm gonna go ahead and wash it for the fourth time. Get some soap. And I'm gonna use it my fifth time after it being washed with soap and water. Four times. So let's do the final test. Let's see if it comes out dirty. You tell me what you think. Did you still see it dirty on the third, fourth, and fifth time? I think I just have very good vision and I can see all this dirt and makeup on it. But maybe you don't see it. Wow, I'm so impressed with this little thing. Use warm water when you use this. That's what the directions say. My ears. Alright, so this is what it looks like. This is what the other side looks like. This is a short haired side. This is a long haired side. Let me see from afar. Let me see. Yeah, I feel like I still see some brown stuff over here. So let me go ahead and wash it. It looks like after being washed. Can you see a difference between the last time I used it, right before I washed it this time, and now? I definitely see a difference. It definitely looks cleaner. Doesn't look like it still has foundation or concealer or mascara or anything like I saw after I cleaned my face last time. So just for the sake of it, let's try cleaning my face one more time. And this time I'm just using one area to see if it picks up anything. My nose, my eyebrows, my eyes. Getting close to my hairline, my ears, my neck. I don't know. Maybe it's just me, but I feel like I still see something there. But even if there was actually still something there, I think this thing did a pretty fantastic job. Because after washing it three times, the other times, like, barely had anything on it. And this thing is small, like I said. Like, it's the size of my palm. This is what it looks like. I don't think I see anything. Alright, so now I'm going to take my handy dandy sponge. And I'm gonna wash my face. So let's go ahead and I'm gonna use Pharma Clear. Just put a little quarter size amount on there. Pat this on different areas of my face. I'm gonna rinse it one last time. I'm gonna go ahead and exfoliate my lips. Glam Glow Pout Mount Fizzy Lip Exfoliating Treatment, like this. And I'm going to put it on my lips and rub it. It has a little minty flavor. And it has like a minty taste. And the directions, I think, says to rub this for 30 to 45 seconds, if I'm not wrong. And now, I'm gonna use my handy dandy sponge to wipe it. Kind of tastes a little sweet. But it tastes like peppermint. I'm just gonna see my sponge. I'm gonna clean the cream. My lips feel super soft. And as a moisturizer, today I'm gonna go ahead and use Origins, a Perfect World Age Defense Moisturizer with White Tea. This is what it looks like. And I'm gonna use about that much. And I'm going to show you the correct way of applying moisturizer, so, in my opinion. So, I'm going to spread it everywhere, and pat it in. And pat it on your neck as well, you don't want to get any premature aging. And to finish it off, I'm going to apply my Mary Kay Indulge Soothing Eye Gel. And this is what it looks like, but to apply it, you're going to go ahead and do the same thing as your moisturizer. And it on. You want to pat it on the top of your eyes too. Pat it on the area where people get the crow's feet. Top of the lid, up to the brow bone. And there you go. I'm ready for bed. And in conclusion, I highly recommend you redeeming some of your points and getting this bad boy right here. It is the original makeup eraser. So I'm very impressed. I'm going to finish it off with the Satin Lips Lip Balm by Mary Kay. And now I'll really be completely ready to go to sleep. Nice and glossy. And that concludes my video. Thank you so much for sticking around. I'm sorry it was a long video, but I hope you enjoyed it, and I will see you on the next one. Bye.